I can't decide between Goodman versus Carrier air conditioners. What do you know about those brands?
Goodman has a reputation for good quality. In reality, they are not so good.
What goes wrong with their units?
Their blower motors sometimes just fall off, because they were out of balance and defective before they left the company.
That might just be one person's horror story.
The Goodman air conditioners leak refrigerant through the coil in the air handler or the evaporator coil.
Is it one specific configuration that had this problem, like split AC systems?
When the AC turns out to be mismatched for the ducting, Goodman and installers will say it is within their tolerances. Even though you may not be able to tolerate the noise of a straining fan or failing condenser.
So it is a problem with specific installations.
Goodman air conditioners made between 2005 and 2007 experienced these failures en masse. That's why there was a lawsuit against Goodman for their HVAC systems.
I'd be screaming bloody murder if my new AC died.
To top it all off, Goodman air compressors are loud.
Does that mean I should go with a Carrier air conditioner?
Carrier is a decent AC company. They own the Bryant HVAC line too.
What do you think of Carrier?
They did not do a good job of taking care of heat pumps that had problems with defective shift valves.
That's heat pumps. I'm looking at air conditioners.
Their air conditioners tend to last 4 to 6 years before experiencing catastrophic and expensive failures.
That still sounds better than Goodman ACs, which die before their first birthday.
Carrier is good enough to grace a lot of commercial businesses.
Then Carrier is going to have to carry me through the next summer. And a unit that lasts more than a year or two will carry my budget too.